Cloud-ready solutions have helped onboard many companies to the cloud, and certainly Amazon AWS is a very popular choice. One recurring question that gets asked is, how do I back up my servers and data and recover them locally if required? Another question is, how do I incorporate my AWS backups with my on-premise backups and our remote site backups? The other question that needs answering is, how can I back up all of my servers across multiple geographical regions without heavy data transfer costs? In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how CRS Data Protection can offer a comprehensive backup solution for your servers running in AWS or any other cloud platform. I'm also going to show how these backup images can be quickly, even instantaneously restored back to an on-premise virtual infrastructure. I'll quickly explain the workflow for this demo. In the cloud, I have a simple server infrastructure. I have a domain controller, I have a SQL server, and I have an IIS web server. I've deployed a cloud-based recovery point server to store local deduplicated backup data. The cloud-based production servers complete infinite incremental deduplicated backups as often as every 15 minutes to the cloud RPS server. It is possible to archive the recovery points on a scheduled basis to Amazon S3 and Glacier. Back in my on-premise or DR data center, I have a second recovery point server. This recovery point server is receiving backup data from local servers, and it's receiving deduplicated backup data from other sites and the cloud-based recovery point server. This all means that full system backups of the cloud servers can be completed and replicated to the remote site with only a small amount of data transfer. The last part of the demo is a feature called virtual standby. If required, the RPS server can automatically restore the latest backup as a virtual machine waiting to be turned on when required. The virtual standby will maintain up to 31 versions of the full system backup and can automatically reprogram the server's network settings to be appropriate for the new network subnet. This demo is using Amazon AWS as the sample cloud infrastructure. You can see in the AWS console that I have four VMs, a domain controller, a SQL server, an IIS server, and also I have a recovery point server. In the web console for the recovery point server, you can see that I have a plan group called Backup AWS VMs, which contains the three other AWS virtual machines. Now I can select any individual node that's in my configured in my backup console and use the actions menu to select backup now, or I can select the entire group and select backup now, and that will invoke the backup process on each of the virtual machines. I'm going to choose an incremental backup because really I only ever want to do incremental backups. This is called infinite incrementals. We never need to do a full backup, and yet we always have full backups that we could recover for each time we do an incremental backup. Now we can see the spinning wheels as the backup jobs begins, and I can select an individual server, look at the recent events and see that we're doing a backup. I can look at the statistics, so I can see the compression percentage there of 58% and the overall data reduction of 92.28% thanks to the deduplication. I'm backing up three servers here. Two servers have the same operating system, Windows 2012, and one is a Windows 2008 server. So we're getting very good deduplication. I can now see in the recent events that I'm replicating. The backup can finish in literally seconds, and the difference was 23 megs, and that 23 megs is being replicated immediately to my recovery point server, which is on-premise. Now, by default, we replicate immediately, but that can be scheduled for a later point in time for replication. While we wait for the replication to complete, it is actually syncing over an ADSL connection to the lab. We can actually connect to the on-premise recovery point server. You can see here I have numerous plan groups because I'm backing up agentless virtual machines. So virtual machines backing up at the host layer. if you like, I'm backing up a Linux server. I've got some local Windows agents that are backing up. And you can see this backup from AWS plan. And you can see the same servers that I have in AWS, the same process. It's showing the process of the replication. And now it's actually preparing the virtual standby server. So it has received the point in time backup from AWS. It only had to send a very small amount of data over the network, and now it is creating the point in time virtual machine ready to be turned on if required. If I look at my VMware infrastructure, you can see I've got a very simple setup. I have three virtual machines that are currently turned off, and you can see they are a CRS VM and then the name of the server that I've protected in Amazon back to on-premise. Okay, back in my backup console, I can have a look at the virtual machine network configuration, because I'm going to want to stand up these virtual machines in a new subnet that's a different IP range from the subnet that was used in Amazon. So first of all, I can choose the network card type. So VMXNet3 is the high performance NIC for VMware. And I can choose to retain the network settings, which will default to DHCP because that's what's used in Amazon. And or I can specify a static IP address. I'm going to leave the default options, and I'm going to just back out of that option. And from the actions menu, I'm just going to select standby a VM, standby my VM. I'm asked to choose a snapshot that I want to boot up, and there are up to 31 different versions of this virtual machine I can choose from. So I'll just choose the latest version and then select power on VM. I'm going to go through the other two servers. I need to do them actually one at a time. So I'll just select one server and then select standby VM. Choose the point in time that I want to use, which again I'll choose the latest version. And then finally for the third server, select standby VM. Choose a point in time and power on the VM. So that process is going to basically instruct VMware, instruct the vCenter in this case, to power on the virtual machines. And return to my console, my VMware console, I can see my DC server has already been started. And now you can see the SQL server has been started, and finally the IIS server will start. So I'll just connect to the console of the DC, the domain controller, and then we can watch it boot up into Windows. Now the initial boot up might take a little bit longer than you'd normally expect. That's because it's obviously detecting new hardware. Once we get the logon prompt, I can log on, and I'm going to log on with the credentials for the domain, which was customer one domain. And once we logged in, we can see we've actually got the host name information that you get in Amazon in the top right hand corner, and the recovery is complete. Okay, just to recap what the demo was about, we had three servers in Amazon that were backing up to a local repository server using infinite incremental backups with source-side deduplication. Those backups can then be archived off to Amazon S3 and then to Glacier. The cloud-based recovery point server can then synchronize its backup information to a on-premise recovery point server, or a recovery point server in a different cloud, which may contain data from other locations. So they all get the benefit of a global enterprise-wide deduplication. And finally, the backups can be automatically restored to virtual machines. These can be done in advance of when they're required. So when a backup is completed, it will automatically restore to a virtual machine that is waiting to be turned on if required.